The clutch on the pinning got a little hot. Sure, they didn't like me to video, so I didn't. Yeah, but that's something happens when you do not use a car. Parking. 1957, 500 TRC, David Cuttingham.
So that was kind of the last little piece on the car. I mean, all the other mechanical stuff was pretty easy.
Okay. Probably the most desirable car of all time, according to many. And Nart Spider, 67.
Get a hold of the right guy that really knows. And then typically, he's going to know the different places
he's going. They have made.
Tom Shaughnessy is probably he's the number one guy because he's a junker. He's a Ferrari parts junker. So he has a lot of the original pieces. No, actually he didn't. Yeah, I mean,
Rare Wheels collection in Florida.
And it's all the little details. Just little stuff. So it's taken a little bit of time. We had the car 5 years.
So rather than like a
you have a Ferrari heaven in here. Get closer to the pinion and Sir Michael Kaduri of Hong Kong has two cars here. One is this 166 Barchetta MM Ferrari team car. And his 58 Le Mans winning Testarossa. See, this used to be a Master Plus or Pier Bordino.
This is one of the most incredibly gorgeous cars in the entire world. Phil Hill, like four spoke wheel, and the pedal box, center bottom.
Okay. From this heavenly brilliant lineup in here, we move two more usual Ferraris. You can call HETO. A normal Ferrari. F40. How Ferraris we are, we need to look at this. The most valuable car in the whole world. The very first Bugatti Type 57 Atlanta from Moulin Museum. This is the first time we're meeting, so it's quiet. A moment for me.
Congratulations go to the 1936 Bugatti Type 57 engine in Atlantic, designed by Jean Bugatti. Chassis number 57374.
Okay, and there we got Jim Glickenhouse creations, the wonderful race cars that he created, inspired by Ferrari, of course. Here it is. W Motors newer car, the year.
I hate the story.
GTS, 275, another gorgeous GTS, and let's say that is for now.